Winter. Hello there, fellow gamers. I'm Kevin Jane. Welcome back to some more Pokemon White version. In the last part, we made our way here to Route 4, and we defeated Bianca, and we took on some people and stuff, and now we've come here to Route 4, where it's all deserty and blizzardy and sandstormy, and it's friggin' scary. Really quick, I'm just gonna make sure my team is healed. I did some training off-screen here. As you can see, Liz is up to level 23. Snake grew 2 levels to level 18. By the way, we got him last episode. He's the brand new member of our Pokemon trainer crew. I don't know. So yeah, Liz is now higher leveled. Snake's a little bit higher leveled. We're gonna train him some more this episode now. And the first person we're gonna train against is good old Charon. Bring it on.
Yeah, hey, Kevin J. I've been waiting for you to...
Why is this a Metal Gear voice?
Yeah, Metal Gear. I've been waiting for you to get the insect badge. And now it's time to see which one of us is the stronger trainer. Yeah, I'm Charon.
There we go, we're taking on Charon. I believe he'll definitely be more difficult than Bianca, but at the same time, I think we'll be okay. And he sends out a P-Dove. That's okay. I wasn't really expecting you to have just a regular old P-Dove, but that's whatever. Scraggy will definitely have a hard time with that, so we'll switch over to Charles here, because Charles actually doesn't get hurt by the sand anymore. Now that his ability is switched over to Sand Rush. So that air cutter, which would have done a lot of damage to Scraggy, doesn't do that much. Yeah, you'll see right here, yeah. Charles didn't get hurt by that. So we're just gonna hit him with the takedown. It'll probably be enough to take him out, because with Sand Rush boosted on top of that. Oh, it doesn't take enough. Oh, he uses the Roost. I'll still defeat him next turn, though, so it's not that big of a deal. Roost is a really good move. It was one of those moves that, like, when it came in, it really took over the meta for a while. I mean, like, it still is. It's a great healing move for the Pokemon that can learn it. But it has, like, this... It has, like, cool, like, side effects. Like, with the whole, Why does it have a survivor? I just realized that. Wait a minute. Servine. I'm dumb. Totally thought it said Survivor. I'm dumb. Anyway, well, time to... Oh, Leech Seed's okay. Thought he was gonna go for... Thought he was gonna go for a grass move and just wreck my face, but he didn't, so we're okay. That's fine. I think I'm gonna hope that I can take at least one grass move from him. I mean, we're the same level. Let's hope I can take at least one. Leaf Tornado? That. No, we definitely took it, so we're okay. And then we missed the Fury Cutter. Why? What's with this game and making me mad? Why? Why does it do it to me? Well, we live for one more turn, not like it really matters. Let's just hope he misses his Leaf Tornado. Or Grap. Oh, weird choice of moves. Anyway. Well, I know what I'm gonna do from here. That was really silly of me. I don't know why I thought Servine said Seviper. Anyway, we're gonna use Retaliate here. With Sand Rush being a normal type and everything, like, that's gonna do a lot of damage. He's gonna eat his Orange Berry? Citrus Berry? Uses Growth that raises Special Attack 2 stages now. It's a really good move now. Oh no, Attack and Special Attack. No, it's not what it does at all. Whatever Growth does. Stop missing! Stop it. That might take you out because of the Growth. Oh, not enough, but it... Please. Take out. Stop! Stop! What did I do? What did I do to deserve this? There's not even... Oh my god, this game. This game does not like me. Or, the game really likes... Cloud, because Cloud's gonna come in and save the day? I was about to throw in Scraggy, but I mean, I guess. Oh no, he knows Leaf Tornado. It's gonna hurt a lot. Just use Psybeam and hurt him. This is like a crit or something, I swear. Lowers my accuracy. Oh, okay, so Leaf Tornado lowers accuracy. I guess that's why I was missing Takedown, but at the same time, like... Man, this game sucks. Why was it being so mean to me? Hand pour, sweet, hey, cool. Oh, I should have switched out to Liz, but that's okay. Especially since you know Bite. But you know what? We're just having fun. We're just having fun. We still hurt them a lot. We're gonna get the scary music again. I'm just gonna go for the Psybeam. Just screw it. Yeah, whatever. We're just letting people get experience today. That's what we're doing. That's why I'm letting them get defeated. And Liz is gonna come in. Liz can definitely take the Panpour easily. I think Charon only has 3 or 4 Pokemon. I don't know. I'll just use Magical Leaf. That way we know we won't miss. Oh, I thought I was gonna flinch there. I was like, oh, but then we flinched because the game hates me. But it's okay. Magical Leaf, hooray, you're defeated. Get dunked. And the Liepard's the last Pokemon, which we can use Snake for, although Snake doesn't have a fighting move yet. But Snake will do alright, because he resists Dark like it's nobody's business. And we can just, you know, headbutt the crap out of the thing. Especially with that Sandstorm slowly whittling down both teams. Oh, really? That's fine. Let me use that headbutt once. Let's take the risk here. I'm gonna use Swagger, because Snake takes a lot of damage here. Oh, come on. 4 times, that's really good. You know me, if I had Fury Swipes, it would only hit once. I'm taking the risk here, because I'm getting that confusion off. If he hits himself, he's done. If not, it's okay. We did it! Yeah! Good job, Snake. You won your first battle all on your own. Level 19. Learn Arm Thrust or something. Nope. I really wanted to learn a fighting move. But it's okay. It's now clear to me. The reason why you are so tough is the trust between you and your Pokemon.
But that shouldn't be a problem. I can get more of my survival and my other Pokemon too.
Dibble-dibble-dibble-bop. I can't time it up. I'm not sure what the... Hello there! Kevin J, do you have a second? Professor Juniper.
Professor Juniper, do you need something?
I called Bianca too, but I guess she didn't hear the call. I wonder what she's caught up in. Well, I suppose I'll just have to call her again later. Okay, I'll be waiting for you two in front of the gate to Nimbasa City. Hello? What? That was weird.
Hello?
Nimbasa City gate is Route 4. Okay. That was a weird conversation, not gonna lie. Maybe I didn't read it properly, because I do that all the time when I'm recording. I just don't pay attention, because it's whatever. Alright, we're all healed up. I was drinking some tea in the middle of that. Alright, and then we're gonna head down Route 4. Now they're all healed up. Deep in the desert ahead of here, at the desert resort, there are some ruins that have become a little tourist destination. Okay, cool, great, awesome. So anyway, you can skip a lot of these trainers, which I will do. Which, by the way, those trainers that were over by the... Not the town map. The trainers that were over by the, What am I doing? What is wrong with me? Dowsing machine. I just want this turned on. The trainers that were over by the water at the beginning of Route 4, they were trainers, they were fishermen. Oh, I should have figured he was gonna turn and look around. Well, whatever, I don't mind doing some battles. But yeah, they were trainers, they were fishermen. We used them to train Liz a little bit. Because they only had Basculins. Waylon as a Blitzel. I think Snake can deal with this. I hope Snake can deal with this. Why would you bring an electric type into it? I don't even know why you would do this. You're gonna use a Swagger because you need the help, all the help you can get. I like how the Infinity symbol is fire in Japanese. No, yeah it is, yeah it is. Because that's what Okami is. You have to do like that shape and it sets things on fire. Okay, and then I'm gonna use Headbutt and hopefully he hits himself at least once. Yeah, did you see how much damage you took? Oh my goodness, Scraggy, look at you! Oh, he did- He does have Moxie! That just made my night, he does have Moxie. I thought, oh, it doesn't activate if the Pokemon dies by its own thing. That's a beautiful thing. That is a beautiful thing. So Moxie, the ability, means that as soon as a Pokemon is, as soon as that Pokemon is defeated, or as soon as that Pokemon defeats another Pokemon, sorry, I don't know why I lost my train of thought there. As soon as that Pokemon defeats another Pokemon, it raises its attack by 1. It's just that good. Scraggy's one of those weird Pokemon where literally all of its abilities are good. Like, literally all of them are good. I guess that's how we get to the resort. I want you to look away. Yeah, this is how you get to the resort. We don't want to go to the resort yet. So we're not going to the resort. Okay. We want to go under this production value again. Oh, he's gonna look. He's gonna look when I run. Luckily, we got past him and we're at the gate out of Route 4 and into Nimbasa City. There we go. But yeah, all Scraggy's abilities are good. That's what I was saying. All Scraggy's abilities are good. He gets Shed Skin, which is good if he's a tank set. Moxie is great for sweeping because he has access to Dragon Dance. And his hidden ability is Intimidate, which is really good as a lead set, or it's really good in doubles too. Hello, Kevin J.
Come here.
That was really... Lisa called and was asking me all about electric-type Pokemon. I thought of you guys. That's why I wanted to see you. Ta-da! Freebies for you! Here, Charon. You too, Kevin J. Ultra Balls. I was supposed to have to do electric-types. Why'd you even... If you see Pokemon that you want to have join you, be sure to use a good type of Pokeball, like a Pokeball, because this could be the first and last time you see that Pokemon. You're talking about shinies, right? Don't tell me you're foreshadowing things, you Juniper. Don't you tell me. Don't you tell me you foreshadowing. Accidentally slurred a word and then turned it into an accent.
It seems the professor gave us a Pokedex as a reason to send us on a journey. At least that's what my mom told me. They want us to go out and see the world. So my mom, Bianca's mom, and your mom made a request to Professor Juniper. Kevin J, what should we do now? I think I'd like to show the professor my thanks by going to Route 4 and catching some Pokemon I haven't yet caught. Well, I've seen most of them, except for maybe a Yamask, which you can also catch in the desert there, but I don't really want it.
Anyway, look at the electric bullets in Nimbasa City. No, I don't want to do that, you silly. We're here in Nimbasa City, where everyone loves the music and Team Plasma's up to something, so we don't get to listen to music for that long.
Gramps, we know you run the daycare.
How do you know? How do we know? Because we're Team Plasma. Team Plasma, we are taking Pokemon away from people. Why do I read their names sometimes? Because I'm dumb. Since you work at the daycare, we figure you must have a lot of Pokemon.
Hand them over.
What kind of nonsense is this? Oh, a strong working trainer, please help me.
Please help me.
If you're gonna get in our way, we'll take your Pokemon too. Whoa. And we gotta hear Pokemon Plasma's theme. Plasma theme's music. Anyway, sorry, that gets me every time. This music gets me every time. It's so good. So good. Anyway, how am I gonna defeat a Watchog? Well, you always gotta start off. That's fine, because I'm just gonna use Faint Attack from here on. I'm really dancing with the devil here by using Swagger on everything. But that's okay, because I'm gonna use Faint Attack. I don't think one attack will take me out, and chances are they hit themselves within two attacks. But then again, I've been testing my luck. I'm still testing my luck so far, so bam. Faint Attack, whoop, bam. Yeah, Faint Attack hurts. Like, Scraggy's got a lot of damage, considering he's only level 19. I mean, we're the same level, of course, but I mean, we're doing really good. Like, we're doing really good. Yeah, Faint Attack. Moxie, oh, I'm just gonna keep him in.
Oh, yeah,
I'll just keep him in, and we'll just sweep everything. And he's learning a fighting move. Oh my god, it's over. It's already over. It's already done. Snake's already the best Pokemon on the team. Already, like, easily. Oh my god. I'm so hyped right now. Trubbish? Sure, I'll keep battling. I don't even... Moxie's activated. We're just gonna sweep through the rest of your team now. You're done. Gets defeated by Sludge somehow. Instantly knocked out. What the... So the thing about... Oh, that crit. I was gonna say, I'm like, why did that do so much? That still would have two-shot him to begin with. And we got another Moxie boost. If he has another one, we'll stay in, but it doesn't matter. I was just trying to train Snake, and now he's just wrecking things.
This went downhill fast.
Yeah, because Moxie. So I think we better run! Let's hide out at the amusement park. Man, you should watch them run off and like, well, I guess I know where they are.
Thank you so much. Please take this as a token of my gratitude. It's a brand new bike. I'd always been planning on riding around Nimbasa City, but I never ended up riding it.
That's a nice looking bike. I'm not gonna lie. I wish I had a bike like that. Put the bicycle in the key item's pocket.
I have a daycare on Route 3. If you have any Pokemon you want me to raise, drop them off. I just came to sightsee, but I got in a lot of trouble. Goodbye.
Hey, Kevin J. Yoo-hoo!
Man, I just want to bob my head to her music.
The professor told me Nimbasa City has a lot of things to see and do. The amusement park, big stadium, small court, and the battle subway. I'm gonna go see the Pokemon musical. See you later.
Pokemon musical is the contest thing. We probably won't do it in this game because I just really don't want to. We're gonna quickly heal at the Pokemon Center, and then we're gonna head over to the amusement park, I think. Methinks. Cause that's where the gym is as well.
Thank you for waiting.
We've restored your Pokemon to full health. Hope to see you again.
Anytime.
And then we're gonna head off. Yeah, there's not much to do in Boston City. The nice thing about Generation 5 is that it's pretty linear. At least that black and white one. We're all pretty linear and I didn't have to worry about too much. Oh, hello.
You're looking for Team Plasma, right? They ran into the amusement park. Come with me.
Uh-oh. The music's so good. They're not here. Let's ride the Ferris wheel and see if we can spot them. I love Ferris wheels. The circular motion, the mechanics. They're like collections of elegant formulas.
You like math.
Okay. This is kind of creepy. But production value. First, I must tell you, I am the king of Team Plasma. Getz has asked me to work with him to save the Pokemon. I wonder how many Pokemon exist in this world. At this time, I think it was around 640 or something.
Been more than that. My Lord N. Team.
You're safe, sir.
I almost read his name again. There's no problem. You're part of the people we brought to help us save the Pokemon, so you're under my protection as well. Go quickly and let my battle cover your retreat. Now then, Kevin J, do you follow my logic?
Yeah, I guess.
If true, your words please me. Ah, then, the future I envision. Perhaps I can't beat you here and now, but I'll battle you to buy time for these members of Team Plasma to get away.
You know what I just realized the voice I should be giving N? Because he's like a sociopath, so he really just should be Light from Death Note. And I realized, the reason why I'm saying this is because I've never watched Death Note until very recently, and I marathoned the whole thing in about 3 days. It's really good. I understand what the hype was for, but I can also understand why some people don't like it, because there's actually not a lot of action, it's just very cerebral. It's good anime to show people how good anime can really be. Because there's so much that goes into anime that isn't just 420 experience. Yeah. There's so much that goes into anime that's more than just Dragon Ball Z. So if someone wants to make the jump from Dragon Ball Z and Pokemon and stuff to other things, Death Note's a good wow. Well, he is 2 levels higher. That's fine, Scraggy. You've been doing far better than I expected. And his doesn't have Moxie, so we're fine. I would have swept my team otherwise. It's okay, I'm just going to Leech Seed him. I guess that's a waiting. That's weird. Oh, I got own tempo! Oh! You screwed up, man! Oh my god, the one time own tempo played out. Only on a handful of Pokemon like Spinda. Good thing I need Mega Drain. Anyway, I guess we'll end the episode after this. Because, you know, we're just taking things out. Number 3 hurts, but it's okay. But yeah, Death Note's really good, like, having Marathon that, and I just came off the heels of, like, Erased and stuff. So I was like, I really wanted something psychological like that, and Death Note was very good. And it is really good, like, it's a really good anime. I highly recommend it. I might actually watch, like, the movies and stuff, because the movies seem pretty true to the anime, and the anime is pretty true to I don't know why I went to Charles, I should have gone to Duat, but... that's okay. Jeez, that hurt. If I go down, I'm taking you with me! And we both go down. Except, I don't think... oh, okay. Thought there was something where it's like you don't get the recoil on that. Yeah, we're gonna throw a nickel. But yeah, it's just, I really enjoyed it. It was really good, it was nice and cerebral, made me think. The ending wasn't, like, the ending was, the thing with the show is, like, it's what, it has what I call, first arc syndrome. And by that I mean, the premise is so good, that the very beginning and the way it sets up everything is so good, that you, like, love it, but then the rest of it, like, kind of pales in comparison, and like by the time it ends, it's kind of like the ending wasn't as good as the beginning. The first season of Attack on Titan was the exact same. The first 13 episodes were, no spoilers, it's really good. I loved it, and then the last 13 episodes, I didn't like it. So anyway, we talked about anime while fighting Ann. I guess it's because he's a very anime character. You're quite strong, but I have a future that I must change, and for that future, I take this potato chip and eat it. I defeat the champion and become unbeatable, unlike any other. I'll make all trainers free their Pokemon. Just try and stop me. If you want to be together with Pokemon, your only hope is to collect the badges from each area and head for the Pokemon League. Try and stop me there if you dare. Wow, you rhymed. If your conviction is not strong enough, you will never be able to defeat me. Well, don't worry, we're getting through this whole Let's Play and we'll get there. There's an item over here. Super Repel, hey, I can't really complain about that. I also didn't even realize, like, there's this whole southern part to this... to this place. Anyway. So the gym's right here. It's actually a roller coaster ride, which is really cool, and we'll get to see that all next time! So, next time on Pokemon White Version, we are going to take on the Nimbasa City Gym, and it's gonna be exciting and it's gonna be fun. Oh guys, you gotta be there. It's gonna be great. Anyway, thank you all so much for watching, and I will see you guys all next time.